And a shorty clean the penis, I'm a diamond and the run it back. Used to have a silver tooth, but I was just a pup. Now I got some killers who got shotties with the I don't wanna catch the feelings, I be trying to see what's up. How that shorty clean the penis.
We're at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one, as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. And that is incomplete.
That's some good closing speed there defensively, because that looked open for a minute. But that's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up, converged on his man, and broke the play up.
Here's second and 10. From the gun, Jackson. A short throw caught by Andrews. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Jackson looking to throw on third. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And the Eagles are going to take over here up near the 40.
Well, they certainly weren't afraid to let it fly early, and they hope that'll keep the defense honest and keep the offensive guys excited about getting back out there. They are in attack mode in this game. It did backfire a little bit. Now you're just hoping your defense can keep them off the scoreboard so you're not facing a deficit the next time you run out there.
And they'll begin on the ground with Gainwell. And a pretty good burst there as they get this across midfield and down to the 46. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
First carry for DeAndre Swift. But he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. It's another first down as they bite off 23 more on that one. They went with the nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that, the nickel look. 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then, you take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you're taking a big off for a little. And oftentimes you can run the football effectively against that defense.
And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. So back-to-back big runs, picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing lane. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
And they didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
It's a gain of a yard. Brings up second and goal at the 3-yard line.
Now they send a man in motion right. Smith catches left side. Touchdown, Eagles! Devontae Smith on the receiving end from Jalen Hurts. And the Eagles use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Had the option there, read it perfectly, and an easy little touchdown toss.
And it has to be a sharp throw, too, because of where they are on the field, the extra traffic, things are condensed near the goal line. Good route by the receiver as well.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. He's got it, and the Eagles lead it 7-2. Touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, or they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
But no matter your experience level as a quarterback, you throw an interception on that first drive, maybe a little shaken up. Nice response there to get their first down.
I think you make an excellent point. I don't care who you are.
Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. That sack courtesy of the effort of Hassan Reddick.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
They're giving him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
Flushed out right. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So after the big play on fourth, here's first and 10. Jackson. That one into the hands of Flowers. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Here's Jackson. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Picked up by Justin Evans. And the Eagles are going to have it here at their own 9-yard line.
Definitely not the ideal time to see that mistake, partner, because this is still a one-possession game, and that's at least a field goal that just vanished with that turnover. Now, pressure's on defensively to prevent that pick from turning into points for the other side.
And just not much to be had there. 1 yard out to the 10. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they're looking at a second down and 9 to go.
No, touch that. 73. Michael Hornet. Crowd left Yeti.
No, touch. Here's Hurts to throw. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. And he will bring this back. It's a pick six and a Raven touchdown. Well, it turns out it's not their offense who gets him on the board first, CD. It's the defense coming through right there with a pick six.
And I know from experience throughout the week, when you go against the offense, you're challenging them all the time. You're letting them know, hey, don't worry about scoring this week. We'll take care of it. We'll get a few pick sixes and score ourselves. You're just kidding? But how about what he just did right there? Laid it out for the rest of the game. We scored. Hey, offense, can you keep up with us?
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
No touch.
They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
They suspected that it was a power play up the middle coming at them. And boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Now a handoff coming left is Gainwell. And he stopped immediately there. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Now third down and seven.
63.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Oh, it's complete. A diving grab there by Brown. And he's going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post route run, they do not like to let it end without the catch. Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it up there, let him go get it, and he got it. Here's a quick throw caught by Smith. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Good work after the catch, going to net him 23 and a first. They will run straight ahead with Swift. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up at seven. This is second and eight. This is Smith. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
First and goal at the 6-yard
line. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. As he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down.
Great, set. Delta.
They'll run here with Gainwell. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Kenneth Gainwell, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles have taken the lead. They go I formation, fullback leads the way for the touchdown. Sort of a lost art, isn't it?
It really is, but sometimes when you're able to bring it back and use it against other teams, they're not prepared for it. They haven't seen it in a while, and now you gain an advantage, and we just saw that advantage result in a touchdown.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively. Obviously, two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe break the ice a little bit? Like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week? Not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
And he'll go right back to Andrews. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Now Lamar changing the look. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. And this is going to be intercepted.
Picked off by Isaiah Rodgers.
And the Eagles are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Now, I'm not sure that the wheels, Charles, are coming completely off, but they're shaking a little bit. That's three interceptions and now interceptions here on back-to-back drives.
And I think about what a Hall of Fame coach told me that he always told his teams, when a mistake happens, just move on to the next play. Let it go. Hard to do when you're throwing this many interceptions. That's exactly the attitude that has to be adopted.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts.
Going deep here for Watkins. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
They gave it a shot with a deep pass, but it wasn't going to work there. And now there's less time for them to try and get three before the half. Let's see what they dial up on this next snap.
Throwing is Hurts.
And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
On third down, here comes Swift.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. A one touchdown ball game, 14-7. Our scores, we get back at it on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead now, a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up
touchdown! Kenneth Gainwell with his second touchdown of the night. And the Eagles come right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter.
I guess when you look back on it, it was just a matter of time until he popped a big one like that. And, you know, at halftime, you and I discussed it. They had done a nice job on him in the first half. But there were a couple of occasions where it felt like he might wiggle out of traffic and take it to the house. Finally here in the second half, that got done.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and it's now 21-7. Touchdown. Here's Elliott on to kick it away.
Duvernay now going to bring it out. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Baltimore offense at the line set to get going.
They make their second half debut here. Things are looking a little bit tougher now. You give up the points there, Charles, that touchdown drive on the other side. So now it's a two-score game here. Got to be careful.
They certainly do, and I'm just wondering at halftime if those guys just looked into each other's eyes and realized what they've got to get done. and come out a little bit more charged up, because if they don't get some kind of points here, that next drive, that could make this a free possession game.
And Andrew's going to have a Ravens first down as he'll get this up to the 34-yard line.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains, because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Being chased out left. Oh, looking for Andrews downfield. The flag comes in. It's incomplete. And I'm not sure he was still behind the line when he let that one go. He broke that line of scrimmage and then let it fly, and that's an automatic flag.
Yeah, and you know, you don't just lose the 5 yards there, but you lose a down as well. So he obviously needs to have better awareness about what he's going to do. Either tuck it and go, or throw it to a target and get that pass away.
So the illegal forward pass also costs him a down, and now it's second and long. From the gun, it's Jackson. They're looking deep here for Flowers. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked by Kevin Byard. Now he's free at the 35. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way.